Welcome to another Power BI tutorial. Today we will show you how to connect to MariaDB MySQL Server through direct query change detection. You can connect to SQL Server in near real-time this way, updating data in frequency as low as 1 second. There are two types of MySQL servers. One is the MySQL owned and maintained by Oracle Corporation, while the other is a fork or spin-off of MySQL called MariaDB. MariaDB is open source and maintained by community. The clarification is important because mostly people call MariaDB MySQL as well, and most applications do not cause an error connecting to a MariaDB server through MySQL connector, which may result in problems later on, such as unavailability of certain features or lack of performance. So, before selecting one in Power BI, make sure you know exactly which one is it you are actually connecting to, and use the right connector. We will use MariaDB, therefore let's select that one. Both MariaDB and MySQL do not have built-in connectors in Power BI, which means you have to use a third-party connector. Connector for MySQL is provided by Oracle, while you can visit MariaDB website to get a connector for MariaDB server. Let's visit the MariaDB website and get a connector for Power BI. You can search for a connector in your browser, which will directly take you to the relevant page. Search for MariaDB connector for Power BI. Go to this link, which also mentions DirectQuery. Locate and click on the link, which will let you download the connector. Here you can choose a connector based on your product and operating system. For Power BI, select ODBC connector. Select an appropriate version of the connector. Sometimes, one version does not work, you can uninstall that one and install another. You can use the trial and error method to select the appropriate version of MariaDB connector. Select the operating system and its appropriate version from this list. And finally, click on the download button to download the MariaDB connector. The connector is of few megabytes, therefore it will take few seconds to download the file. Once the file is downloaded, start the installation. And when the installation is over, close the window and go back to the Power BI application. Now, you can click on the Continue button and connect to the MariaDB server. Here you have to enter the server name, database name, and the appropriate credentials to access the database. If you want to practice, we have provided a MariaDB server, which you can use here. Go to our website and navigate to the resources page. Here you will find the IP address, database name, and credentials to our MariaDB server. Copy the IP address and paste it into the data source field. Then, copy the name of the MariaDB server database from our website and paste it in the database field. You will need appropriate credentials to access this database, which consists of username and password. Both are provided on our website. Copy the username from the web page. Choose Direct Query as data connectivity mode. On the next screen, paste the username into the username field. And copy the password from the web page and paste the password into the password field. Click on the Connect button to connect to the database. If connected successfully, you will see the Navigator window. Select the Digital Den sales table and click on the Load button. Once the connection is made, the data will be loaded in the data pane on the right corner of the Power BI application. Add a text box to your dashboard and type the name of the organization. Place the text box at the top of the dashboard. Go to the format options and change the background of the text box to black. Change the font color to white and font size to 40. Also make it bold. Now, resize the text box and place it properly at the top of the screen. Make a copy of this text box and place it right below the existing one. Enter the title of this dashboard and change the font size to half. Change the background color of this text box to dark red. Make necessary adjustments to these text boxes. Next, drag the sales field to the dashboard. This will create a card visual displaying total sales. Turn off the category label and change the font size to 20. Change the font color to white and remove background of this card visual, making it transparent. Now, place this card visual on the top right corner of the dashboard, right before the title of the dashboard. Add a pie chart to your dashboard. Add the sales field to the values. Add the category field to the legend. Place this chart at the top left corner of the dashboard. Create a duplicate of this chart and place it at the top right corner of the dashboard. Replace the category field with the type field to display sales by type. Add visual borders to both charts. Add the sales field to the dashboard and change the visual to a line chart. Add the date field to the x-axis of the line chart. Place the line chart at the bottom of the dashboard. Turn on visual borders of the line chart as well. Our dashboard is now complete. However, this dashboard does not display real-time information. To update this dashboard, we will have to click on the refresh button. But since we chose DirectQuery as data connectivity mode, we can make this dashboard real-time at any time we want. To do that, we simply have to turn on the page refresh option. We can then either update data at fixed interval, which can be as low as 1 second. Or we can use the change detection mode, which will update data only when data is changed. Click on the add change detection to tell the Power BI how to detect if data has been changed. We can choose one of the calculations to determine if data has been changed. Maximum is suitable for index or serial numbers. We will go for the sum. We can also choose how often to check for change, and again, we can choose frequency as low as 1 second. Select the sales field as change detection field. Now, whenever the sum of sales changes, the Power BI will know that the data has changed, and it's time to update the dashboard. Click on the Apply button to add the change detection mechanism to your report. It will be added to the data pane. Now, we have a real-time, or almost real-time dashboard. How to test this dashboard? We have created a script which enters random sales values to this sales table. Copy this URL and go back to the dashboard. On the dashboard, add a new button and place it at the top right corner of the dashboard. Turn on actions for this button and select web URL. Then enter the URL you copied into the web URL field. Enter an appropriate text for this button and change the font size to 20. Our button is now ready. Whenever we will click on this button, random sales data will be added to the sales table. Press the Control key and click on this button to navigate to the web URL. Go back to the dashboard and see the sales data change. The data has been changed from 42.16 to 42.17. Every time you click this button and come back to the dashboard, you will observe that the value of sales has changed. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.